Thank you.
I did like Ms. Jackson.
If you want to be nasty.
My last husband, I had a detective follow him.
Tell me the truth, Carl. Who have you been sleeping with?
You have no idea how much I hate coming up into this house sometimes.
You're saying a lot, Carl. You're saying a lot without saying nothing at all.
I'm sorry.
Save your sorry. One thing I don't need are any more apologies. You know, you were always being inconsistent. Beating my heart to death talking about you're sorry. You know what? I'm gonna put a sign. A sign on the door. Better yet, I'm gonna leave a voicemail. A message on my voicemail. If you call to say you're sorry, then call somebody else. I got sorry greeting me at the front door. You can keep yours.
Now, this is your third Tyler Perry film.
Mm-hmm.
Now, I know that you've done Why Did I Get Married and everything else. Was there any hesitation or did you have any doubt in your mind that Tyler Perry could tell Nzake's, Shange's work for Colored Girls, speaking from like a women's?
Not at all. Not at all. I think he has this knack and understands women, and it really shows in his work. And the depth of Tyler, I think people have even yet to truly see, and what he could, excuse me, show through his talent. People have yet to truly see. Not at all. I thought it was brilliant the way he fused his words with her poetry. I thought it was very well done. That's not an easy thing to do at all. And he did it very well.
Were you familiar with Ms. Shange's work before the project?
No, I wasn't. I knew who she was from when I was a kid doing Good Times and going to New York on my hiatus to visit Mike. He was doing The Wiz, and for Colored Girls Who Have Considered Suicide When the Rainbow Is Enough, I remember this long title. That's how I remember the play. I thought, oh my God. And I knew it was an all-black female cast. Excuse me. But I never saw the play.
Okay. How was it working with this ensemble cast? I mean, you have great actresses all around you and a great director. How was that experience?
It was a wonderful experience. Everyone got along so well on the set. I feel badly because I chose not to enter. Excuse me. I chose not to interact with the rest of the girls because of the character, to try and stay true and stay in character. And she wanted nothing to do with that world and those people, as she would say, and kept that wall up. But I had one scene with all of the girls, and I loved it. It's like, you know, going to school. I was trying to stay in character, but yet watching them at work, and I thought it was absolutely beautiful.
Or saying sorry a million times.
We all have I'm sorry stories, don't we?
Get this, just last week, my ex-old man comes in saying, baby, I don't know how she got your number. I'm sorry.
No, this is it. Oh, baby, you know I was high. I'm sorry.
I'm only human. If we were perfect, we wouldn't have nothing to strive for. So you might as well go on and forgive me, because I'm sorry.
This one is it. I do you like I do you, because I thought you could take it. No, I'm sorry.
Now, I know you know I love you. But I ain't gonna love you the way you want me to love you. Sorry.
Now, your character, Joe, she's introduced to us in one scene where she's kind of being hard on somebody that's coming to get charitable donations. Now, I know, you know, you and your family's been done a lot for charity and everything else. Is it sometimes hard to be able to, like, choose what you can and what you can't participate in?
Yeah, it is difficult because you want to, at least I should say, I'm this way. I want to help everybody and give to everybody. But there's only so much you can do at a time, so it becomes more difficult. And for myself, I'm more drawn to things that relate to children, more so than anything. I mean, I've worked with AIDS, with MFAR, and other charities, but I'm more drawn to things that relate to children.
Right. thank you for your time. I look forward to seeing you in many more films and back in your music career.
Thank you.
I still call you Miss Jackson.
If you want to be nasty.
Another song with no singers, lyrics, no voices, and uninterrupted solos, unseen performances. Are we ghouls?